This is Pastor Cuthbertson, and I am here at the Pentecostal Faith Assembly Church, along with some of the saints of God who have come for a worship and word service. We are here to help you to know that our God is still worthy of praise. This is the Lord's house. We give him praise.
Glory to the name of the Lord.
This is the Lord's day. We honor him.
Glory to the name of the Lord.
We are the Lord's people. We serve him.
Glory to the name of the Lord.
All praises, all honor to the Lord our King.
Glory to the name of the Lord.
As we have come today to this place of worship, we come in prayer. And it is now prayer time in the assembly. And wherever you are, I want you to know that God hears and answers prayer. Whatever your petition is, we're going to allow you a moment to just make that prayer request known unto God. And now we want you to know as we pray, whatever you have made mention of to God, please know that our God knows what to do with it. Please join me as I pray. Lord, we thank you again because you have given us the honor and the privilege to be able to bow our heads before you. We thank you, God, because we know that you hear prayer. You answer prayer. You move because of prayer. And we thank you, God, that you have given us this privilege. And as we come, we pray, God, for your blessings. We pray, God, that you would move among the songs and the worship. We ask, God, that you would even bless the word that is ministered to today to your people. Amen. We thank you, God, because we know that you hear us. And we know, God, that you will remember the petitions that your people have placed before you. We pray, God, for every soul everywhere, every man, woman, boy, and girl. We ask, God, that your will be done. Lord Jesus, we know that there is nothing too hard for you. There is nothing you cannot do on our behalf, or nothing you cannot do because you desire to do it. Lord, we pray that you would work mighty works. We pray, God, that you would continue to perform miracles. We pray, God, that you would continue to bless, heal, deliver. Let your will be done, God. We trust you. We trust your word. We trust you. Our confidence is in you. We ask, God, that you hear us as we pray and help us always to call upon your name. We thank you for all things and pray that everything would be done in the blessed name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen and amen.
Amen. Anybody come to worship him today? Amen. We need the Holy Spirit of God to rest upon us, to be in our lives. And we've come today to invite the presence of the Lord. And will you help us to worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords? Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, God. We worship you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Oh, there's nothing worth more that could ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living hope. Your presence, Lord. Oh, I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of loves, where my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. Your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are.
Holy Spirit, you are welcome here.
Come flood
this place and fill the atmosphere.
Your glory,
God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by your presence, Lord.
Your presence, Lord.
Your presence.
Oh,
there's nothing worth more than could ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living hope.
Your presence, Lord.
Your presence, Lord.
Oh, I've tasted and seen, yes.
I've tasted and seen
of the sweetest of love.
Where my heart becomes free.
And my shame is undone. Your presence, Lord.
Your presence.
Come on, lift your voice with us and sing.
Hey, Holy Spirit, you are
Holy Spirit, you are welcome.
Come flood this place.
Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere.
Your glory, God.
Your glory, God, is what my heart longs for. To be overcome.
Come on, we'll say that again.
Say, Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit, you are welcome.
Lord, come.
Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere.
Your glory, God.
Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for.
To be overcome
by your presence, Lord.
Come on, sing your presence, Lord.
Your presence, Lord.
Come on, lift your hands right where you are. If you're excited about the presence of the Lord, in his presence, bodies can be healed. Yokes can be destroyed. Nothing like his presence.
Hallelujah, yes. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness.
Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness.
Oh, let us become.
Let us become more aware of your presence.
Let us experience
the glory of your goodness.
Come on, let's give God some praise. Let us become more aware of the presence of the Lord.
Holy Spirit, you are welcome here.
Come flood
this place and fill the atmosphere.
Your glory,
God, is what our hearts long
to be overcome
by your presence, Lord.
Holy
Spirit, you are welcome here.
Come flood this place
and fill the atmosphere.
Your glory, yes.
Your glory, God,
it's what our hearts long for.
To be overcome
by your presence,
Lord.
Your presence, Lord.
Your presence, Lord.
Come on, let's give God words of adoration. Let's give God words of praise. We've come to fill this place with praise and worship. For when the praises go up, the blessings come down.
Come, Holy Spirit, fill us now, God. Fill us with your anointing. Fill us with your power, God. We can't make it without you. We can't survive without you, God. Oh, we love you, Jesus. Oh, yeah, yes. Yeah, yeah, yes.
Come on.
Holy Spirit, you
are welcome here.
Come flood
this place. place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by your presence, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We lift you up, Lord Jesus. Nobody like you. Hallelujah.
Our scripture reading, Colossians chapter 1, verses 22 through 23. Verses 21, rather, through 23. And you who were sometime alienated and enemies in your mind by wicked works, yet now hath he reconciled in the body of his flesh through death to present you holy and unblameable and unreprovable in his sight, if ye continue in the faith, grounded and settled, and be not moved away from the hope of the gospel which ye have heard and which was preached to every creature which is under heaven, where am I am made a minister. God bless the reading of the scripture.
Amen. There's nothing like the strength of the Lord. In times like these, when there's so much going on, we need the strength of God in our life. Come on, lift your hands with us and let's begin to give God worship. You are my strength, strength like no other. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, you are my strength. Yes, strength like no other. Strength like no other. Reaches to me. You are my strength, strength like no other, strength like no other. Reaches to me. You are
my strength.
Come on, sing with us. Strength like no
strength
other.
Like no other.
Strength like no
strength
other.
Like no other.
Reaches
to me.
Come on, say it again. You are my strength.
You are my strength.
Oh.
Strength like no other.
Lord, you are my strength.
Strength like no other.
Oh, and it reaches
to me.
Come on. In the fullness.
In the fullness of your grace.
In the power.
In the power of your name.
You lift me
you
up.
You lift me up.
You lift me up.
You lift me up.
In the fullness.
In the fullness. Oh, of your grace.
In the power.
In the power of your name.
You lift me up.
Anybody ever needed to be lifted?
You lift me
up.
Oh, you are my strength.
You are my strength.
Come on, strength in the midst of difficulty.
Strength like no other.
Strength in the face of adversity.
Strength like no other.
And it reaches
to me.
Come on, say it again.
You are my strength.
You
yes.
are my strength.
Everything I need, Jesus.
Strength like no other.
Lord, in the midst of
strength
trouble,
like no other.
I can stand firm in you, yes.
Riches.
Come on, let's take it out. Oh, fullness.
In the fullness hey, yeah. of your grace.
In the power
yeah. of your name.
Lord, you lift
me up
above my problems, up above my circumstances. Yes.
In the fullness
of your grace,
of
God.
Your grace.
And in the power.
In the power of your name,
Lord, you lift me
up.
I can't make it without you, Jesus.
You lift me up.
Oh, in the fullness, hey, in the power.
Let's give God some praise. Hallelujah. He is our strength. He is our song. He is our shield. He is our buckler. Without him, we will not make it, and we cannot survive. But I'm so grateful for the strength of God and the power of God. Come on and worship him.
We love you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. We love you and we thank you today.
You are my strength.
Come on, help us sing.
Strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
Reaches
to me.
Oh, yes.
Come on, give God the praise if you know that he's your strength. Give God the praise if you know that he's fighting for you. Hallelujah.
And I will give you pastors according to mine own heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding. The Pentecostal Faith Assembly Church family would like to wish a very happy 27th pastoral anniversary to Suffragan Bishop Brenda Cuthbertson. We invite you to attend a virtual celebration in honor of Suffragan Bishop Brenda Cuthbertson this Sunday, October 11th at 7:30 p.m. on Zoom. Please follow our social media pages for the Zoom link and further details.
It's offering time in the Cyber Sanctuary. The Lord loves cheerful givers. Pentecostal Faith Assembly Church has multiple ways to receive your donations 24/7. Download our church's app on your mobile device. Find our PFAC logo at the Apple Store and Google Play and follow the instructions. Give online through our website at www.pfachurch.com. Text the keyword PFA Church to 77977. Or you may mail us at 5347-53 Pulaski Avenue, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, 19144. You are invited to refresh your day with 2 minutes of inspiration with Bishop Cuthbertson every evening at 7:14 p.m. Find us on Facebook at Pentecostal Faith Assembly Church.
Join us every Tuesday for our new ministry series, Unlimited Faith, featuring the ministers of Pentecostal Faith Assembly Church.
Think faith, have faith, work faith. Faith works. So activate your faith with unlimited faith. We are cooperating with current government recommendations, limiting sizable gatherings in an effort to hinder the spread of the coronavirus by suspending all activities at the church facilities until further notice. Follow us on social media for updates. We encourage all who can and will join us on our Wednesday 6 a.m. prayer call. Begin your day with prayer. Call in at 1-605-313-4113 and enter access code 570-016 and press pound. You'll be glad you did. That's 1-605-313-4113, access code 570-016 and press pound. Please keep the number. It is our conference call number. Bishop Cuthbertson would like for all ministry leaders to continually keep in contact with members and others during these difficult days of separation. You can replay our services online at our website, www.pfachurch.com, or locate us on Facebook, Twitter, Periscope, and YouTube, where you can subscribe to our page. Bishop Cuthbertson has received and prepared a word from the Lord just for you. So stay tuned for the message of the day.
How many worshipers do we have with us today who can declare that their worship is for real? We've been through a lot, we've gone through a lot, but it's our worship that has sustained us. And we worship God because he's worthy of the praise. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to your name, Jesus.
God, we worship you, yes.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah. Don't know my story, all the things that I've been through. You can't feel my pain, what I had to go through to get here. You'll never understand my praise. Don't try to figure it out, because my worship is for real. Oh, because my worship is for real. Oh, help us sing.
You don't know my story, all the things that I've been through.
You can't feel
my pain, what I had to go through to get here.
You'll never understand
my praise.
Don't
try to figure it out,
because
my worship is for real.
Oh, say it again, my worship.
Because
My worship is
for real.
The songwriter says,
I've been through too much
not to worship him.
Come on, help us sing.
I've been through too much not
you
to worship him.
Lord, you've been so faithful.
To worship him.
Oh, I've been through too much. I've got to lift my hands and thank you, Lord.
To worship him.
Oh, say hallelujah.
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 Oh, today we're here to say
my worship. Is for
thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
My
worship is for real.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
With all of my heart, all of my soul.
My worship is for
you're so worthy.
You're so worthy.
You're so worthy.
You're so worthy.
And we give you the glory. Yes.
My worship is
let me hear you say yes.
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 Say yes.
Hallelujah.
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 Say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
For everything that you've done.
Thank you, Jesus.
For everything that you've been.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord, I say thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
And Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
From the bottom of my heart.
Lord, I love you.
And to the depths of my soul.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you. I love you. I love
you.
And you're so worthy.
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 Let me hear you
say yes.
Yes.
Yes to his will.
Yes.
Yes to his way.
Yes.
Yes, I'll obey.
Yes,
yes in the morning.
Yes.
And yes in the noonday.
Yes,
yes in the evening.
Yes.
Yes late at night.
Yes,
yes when I feel like
yes.
It. And yes when I don't.
Yes.
God, you have my yes.
Yes.
God, you have my yes.
Yes.
So I lift my hands.
Yes.
And worship your name.
Yes.
You've been good to me.
Yes.
I say yes.
Yes.
Yes in the morning.
Yes.
Yes, in the new day.
Yes.
Everything I have.
Yes.
Everything I have.
Yes.
Tell the devil no.
Yes.
And tell God yes.
Yes.
Yeah, yes.
Yes.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Yes.
Say hallelujah.
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 Come on, give him the praise and give him the glory. Come on, lift your hands and bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Yes to his will and yes to his way. Yes, we'll obey. Come on, give God a praise and tell him yes. We thank you, Jesus. We lift your name, Jesus. We honor your name, Jesus. Nobody like you, God. Nobody greater.
What a blessing it is to be individuals who believe in true and real worship. is your worship for real? I'm so glad today that that's my testimony, and I pray that it becomes your testimony as well. We have been blessed by our worship ministry. They've sung songs of praise and moved into the realm of worship, and certainly they have blessed us tremendously. I say every time we come together that I appreciate the fact that they make the sacrifices that they do each week to come and help us to honor God in our service. And so certainly I thank God for them. And I believe that their testimony is true, that their testimony is real and right, and that their worship is for real. It is time for us to share a word from the Lord. And I'm going to ask you to get your Bibles, get your devices, wherever you have access to the scriptures. We're going into the New Testament, and I want you to follow me into the Gospel of Matthew. The Gospel of Matthew, chapter 7. In the 7th chapter of the Gospel of Matthew, there are 3 verses that I want to read in your hearing, and they are verses 18 through 20. That's Matthew chapter 7, verse 18, 19, and 20. The word of the Lord reads, "A good tree cannot bring forth evil fruit. Neither can a corrupt tree bring forth good fruit. Every tree that bringeth not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire. Wherefore, by their fruits ye shall know them." Will you join me as I pray? Precious God, we are thankful to you for the reading of this word. And our prayer today is that this word would benefit your children, your people, in their walk with you. And also, God, that someone would be drawn to you. We pray, God, that this word would be made plain unto us. We pray for clarity and understanding, as well as insight. And God, I know that you can do it. And most of all, God, we're asking that you allow this word to settle in our spirits. Help us, God, to hide it in our hearts, that we may not sin against thee. We thank you, God, and we pray that these things would be done. In the blessed name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. Whereas I have only read 3 verses, I'm going to reread them again and ask you one more time to follow me there in Matthew, the 7th chapter. Verses 18 through 20. A good tree cannot bring forth evil fruit. Neither can a corrupt tree bring forth good fruit. Every tree that bringeth not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire. Wherefore, by their fruits ye shall know them. These are the words of Jesus, and the thought that I want to leave with you today is simply this. Got fruit? That's right. Got fruit? These are Jesus' words, as I have said. Those of you that have Bibles that perhaps might be the red letter edition, where the words of Jesus, the supposed words of Jesus, are printed in red, you will note that it's in red in your Bible. This was a part of Jesus' sermon on the mountainside. And in Jesus' sermonizing, he covered a broad range of beneficial topics. These topics were given for the follower, for the disciple, for the one who wanted to come to know God. And it was given to those individuals whose desire it was and is to both do and be right. These words were not grievous. They are not hard. They are words that are given to us through the voice of Jesus to help us to know what we ought to do as Christ followers. These are words, however, that could cut to the heart of many matters. When Jesus speaks about attitude. Many of you know when you begin to read the Sermon on the Mount, we hear people talk about the Beatitudes. Jesus spoke about attitude. He speaks about witness, how we are obligated to witness, and what our obligation is as witnesses. He speaks to help us to understand that we are commanded to be light in darkness. This is all involved in his sermon. Also, he speaks and talks about fulfilling, amen, the law. He is the fulfillment of the law and explains that he did not come to destroy it, but he came to fulfill it. We also see where Jesus speaks about anger management. Some of you may have thought that that was something modern, especially if you were sent to those classes. But Jesus speaks about anger management in his Sermon on the Mount. He continues and goes forward with sharing to the people that we ought to live godly and moral lives, and we ought to be involved in godly and moral relationships. Also, we ought to be a people who keep our word. He continues with his sermon and shares with us how to love our enemies, how we ought to love our enemies. And then he teaches us how to pray. Not only how to pray, but he goes on to tell us how we should fast. He speaks about where we are to put our treasure, where our focus ought to be. He talks about us being able to trust God and trust God alone. Along with that, he inserts in there how we can prepare for the kingdom. And most notably in his sermon, he teaches us how not to succumb to the trickery of false prophets, which brings us down to the passages that I have read in these verses. Jesus speaks loudly and speaks and says that one should beware of false prophets. He says that there is a way to define false prophets. You can tell a false prophet by their fruit. Let me tell you what Jesus says with regard to the fruit of the false prophet. The false prophet will lie. Yes, that is their fruit. They will cover themselves and masquerade themselves to be something that they are not. That is the fruit that they produce. They hide themselves. That is the fruit that they produce. They cheat, they lie, they hide, they cover. This is the way of every false prophet. But what Jesus gets across to his followers or those that were hearing what he said, he allowed them to come to the knowledge that every false prophet can be made known or revealed, and they are revealed by their fruit. So he says, by their fruits you shall know them. Let's look for a moment about agriculture. Let's talk about agriculture, excuse me. And let's look at the agriculturalist. Every agriculturalist knows that you cannot produce every fruit that you want to produce but for certain areas. It depends on what is planted. It depends on how you plant it. It depends on how you care for it. All of the plants have to be cultivated. They must be cared for. They must be nurtured and properly harvested. If you don't treat them right, then they will not grow the way that you want them to grow. What I understand from God and God's word is that God has an investment in us. The Bible teaches us that God created what God declared to be good. But what happened along the way, the devil showed a jealous rage and got beside himself. And because of that, the devil decided that he would ruin the crops that God had planted. And so ever since the days of Adam, the devil has been angry and has tried to ruin what God created. But let me tell you something. God had a plan. God has a plan. God, amen, had a plan. And God's plan was not to be undone. As much as the devil wants to undo the plan of God, the devil cannot do that. What is the plan of God? The plan of God is to instill in each and every one of us good fruit. How is that good fruit instilled in us? Well, my friend, it is instilled by the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is that good seed. Amen. And that good seed is planted in what God created as a good people. Amen. And when good seed is planted in good people, then good fruit must come forth. I'll repeat that. When good seed is planted in good people, then good fruit must come forth. Oh, yes, good trees, the word of God is saying through Jesus, good trees do not produce bad fruit. When we look around and we look particularly as Jesus talked about the false prophets, we see bad fruit being produced by them. How do we see it? If the attitude is not right, then that's bad fruit. If the witness is improper, then that is bad fruit. When one refuses to come out of the dark and get into the light, then that is bad fruit. To remain in ungodly relationships in an ungodly way is to be involved with producing bad fruit. If one does not try to keep the word of God planted in your spirit, then you will produce bad fruit. If you don't want to love everybody the way that God wants you to love everybody, then that, my friend, is bad fruit. If you will not pray and you will not fast, that is bad fruit. If you're not trying to make it to the kingdom, but your only interest and focus is the here and now and what you can get or gain, then that is bad fruit. If you spend your life lying like a false prophet, that's bad fruit. If you are living like a false prophet, That is bad fruit. If you are hiding and masquerading in a costume, amen, hiding just like a sheep in wolf's clothing, or a wolf rather, in sheep's clothing, excuse me, then that is bad fruit. But what the Lord wants us to do is to produce fruit, and good fruit at that. Somebody ought to thank God right now. Amen. Tell somebody that this is what the Lord wants. Tell somebody there's good in me. Amen. And therefore good is coming forth. If good is in you, then good has to be the thing that comes forth. Amen. When good is in you, then you don't have to worry about your thoughts. You know, we were singing when I was growing up a song that said, amen, that God taught me how to think. Hey, amen. Change my thoughts so I could think right. Well, God has something that God has placed in us that we don't have to be concerned about our thoughts being right, because if there is good in you or me, then my thoughts are good. Amen. A good individual who has good in them and lives by good principles and allows a good God, amen, to enforce in them the right thing and the good thing, then that individual will live and possess good intentions. They will be good in their walk. They will be good in their conduct. They will look at their own lives and they will say, I have been created by a good God. Hallelujah. And because I've been created by a good God, I am created from good stock, from good stuff. Therefore, I can do good things. I can produce good fruit because I'm a child of a good God. In other words, have you got fruit? You ought to have good fruit. If you got good fruit, then you know what it is to have love, because love is a good fruit. If you have got fruit and that fruit is good fruit, then you've got joy, because joy is good fruit. If you have good fruit, you got peace, because peace is good fruit. If you have gentleness, you got good fruit. If you have goodness, you got good fruit. If you can even deal with long suffering, that's good fruit. Amen. The Bible tells me temperance is one of the fruit of the Spirit. It's a good fruit. Faith is a good fruit. Meekness is a good fruit. Hallelujah. And when you've got good fruit, you've got good fruit from God. Have you got fruit today? Are you showing the world what you're made of? The Bible says, amen, a good tree cannot bring forth evil fruit. Hallelujah. And any corrupt tree cannot bring forth good fruit. But I thank God that I am known by the fruit that I produce. What are you producing today? You need to show the world what God is all about. When somebody looks at you, they ought to see God. Hallelujah. Amen. When they spend time in your company, they ought to see God. Amen. Your testimony ought not to be all talk, but your walk ought to accompany that talk. Hallelujah. Have you got fruit today? What are you producing? You need to show the world, amen, what God is all about. Amen. Come away from the wrong. Come away from the false. Come away from the dark. Come away from the ungodly. Come away from the bad attitude. Come away from the poor witness and show the world, I got fruit. I've got the fruit of God in me. The Holy Ghost has planted a seed, and the only thing that's coming up is good fruit. Good fruit. Good fruit. Have you got fruit today? Amen. Can't you hear Jesus speaking to those who were sitting on the mountainside, listening for a word, and Jesus speaking to them and saying, don't be tempted to follow the ones who produce evil fruit, but follow those who produce good fruit. Amen. Be careful who you follow. Be careful who you listen to. Make sure that they are producing good fruit, because Jesus said, by their fruits ye shall know them. If I were you today, if I were you, I would ask God, search me. Lord, if there is any wicked thing in me, any evil thing in me, Lord, take it away. Let me be your child. Let me be your follower. Believe God's word. Repent of your wrong. Let God cleanse you with the waters of baptism. Let him fill you with the Spirit so that all you produce is good fruit. Have you got fruit? Have you got good fruit? Have you got godly fruit? That's what we need today. My prayer is that God will bless you to come to know God as you have never known God before. And just know, we will all know if you know God. We will all know if you're following God, because your fruit will speak for itself. Will you join me again as I pray? God, I thank you for the word that has been shared with your people. I thank you, God, for the understanding, oh Lord, that it is our obligation to produce fruit. And we're going to produce fruit, that we are. But God, I pray that the fruit that we produce is good fruit. We don't want to produce corrupt fruit. We don't want to produce evil fruit. But we want to produce good fruit. We pray that it will be done in Jesus' blessed name. Amen and amen. Be blessed. Have a wonderful, wonderful day, and be fruitful. Be fruitful and be blessed. Amen.